Dear Texas, y'all would be doing some crazy shit. So, this law is in discussion, and y'all are managing to pass some crazy-ass laws. But this one is the least crazy of all the crazy laws. Texas is going to end the no-fault divorce, and there are multiple states in conversations about ending no-fault divorces. This means if you're going to get a divorce, you now need to prove somebody was unfaithful. You need to prove abuse. You can't just say abuse. You can't just say you're bored. You can't just whatever else. Well, seeing how 80 to 90% of the time it's the woman who ends the divorce, obviously women are going to be rather upset about this. But what this is going to do, it's going to cause you to actually choose your husband well. Actually take care of his needs, because there's going to be no more escape. This is starting to take off like wildfire.
Hey folks, this is Jeff with This Week with JTT. This is about them doing away. I think it started in Texas. They're going to do away with the no-fault divorce. Now, I saw at least about a half dozen videos of women firing back, talking smack, saying, oh, how dare they force us to stay married? No one is putting a gun to your head and saying, you got to stay married. All you got to do is provide the reason why you want a divorce. And like I said before in my other video, there should be these three main reasons why you should divorce your man. One, if he's physically abusive, yes, divorce him. Don't take half his money, take everything. If he's take everything, make him pay the ultimate price. Two, if he has addiction, alcohol, drugs, unless this man is showing that he's, you know, overcoming his addictions and all that, divorce him. Three, and of course not least, adultery. If the guy can't stop and behave himself and can't, like, be faithful to you, you have a right to divorce him. Then you hit the reason why they want to divorce your man. I'm bored. I'm unhappy. I want to do my high school sweetheart. Why on earth? I'll go a step further. If you're so unhappy, if you're so bored, if you want to do some other dude or whoever, then why you got married? I can almost guess why. Because you want that man with the devil's number. In other words, the man might have been over 6 feet tall. He earned six figures. He was in shape, meaning he had a six-pack of abs, among other things. Now, all of a sudden, you want to change your mind and leave? No. When they eliminate the no-fault divorce, guess what? It's going to force your women to take accountability and be responsible. In other words, though, they're really going to make sure you're going to properly vet your future mate. Simple as that. None is like, you know, well, I'm going to leave that. No, no, no. If you're going to call yourself going to divorce your husband and take Lord knows how much out of his, like, you know, life savings, you better provide a very good reason. Simple as that. But like I said, they make a sign where, you know what, number one, no one's forced you to stay in the marriage. Just provide the reason. Plain and simple. That's one. But once again, you women on the TikTok, you're probably on Facebook, Instagram, crying, complaining, firing, trashing men. But here's this. All this blah, 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 blah you women have been doing is backfiring in a big way. And I tell you how. Number one, a large number of men are not going into their dating scene anymore. They stopped. They had enough. You women be complaining, chivalry is dead. Why? You murdered it. Forget killed. You women murdered it. That's one. Two, men are going overseas to find traditional women. Yes, that word that's cancerous to your very being. Yeah, traditional. But for some funny reason, even though you say you don't want men and all that, but the moment the men go overseas to get something they want, they're ashamed for it. Meanwhile, you women can have your preferences all day long, no matter what. But the moment we have preferences, we get shamed and condemned for it. You would say, oh, men's preferences are toxic. So we don't have a choice, but yet we are being accused of making slaves of your women, saying, like, we're making you cook, clean, and have sex with us. For your information, men have been cooking and cleaning forever. In terms of sex, once again, all this, why you even bothering with them? So here's what, ladies. This is for all your modern women who got that mindset of yours, saying you don't need men. Guess what? If the house gets broken into, you better pray to God that there's a police woman there because you got to deal with mail. So you do need mail. Or your house is on fire. Firemen. It's got to be mostly a mail. In other words, maybe police, firemen, what happened, that's a 90% chance it's going to be a mail. So you're going to need a man one way or the other. Your woman gives me a headache, I swear. But you modern woman, the solution is simple. Stay single. Live that hot girl summer for the rest of your life. Or let me take that back. You can't live that hot girl summer until the younger generation replaces you. Yes, once you hit past 35, you think you got to outcompete a girl in her early 20s? No, you're not. I'm sorry. And don't get it wrong. I see women who are like in their 30s and 40s. They're beautiful. But those girls who are in their 20s, you're not gonna outcompete them. No, you're not. And they're always coming up every year. You got a newer girl coming up. Sorry. And men your age is going to keep walking away. Then we have more videos of women crying. Oh, why can't we find the good men? Why? Where's all the good men? Because you modern women chase them away. If anything, I feel bad for the good traditional women. So once again, to all the traditional good women, you know, keep holding it down. Don't give up. Please don't give up. Keep your head up high. If you have to start making the first move and all that, until then, peace, God bless.